Hey everyone, it's Hayes, and in today's video we are going to be comparing the three outfits we have for the Ladybug Miraculous. Now, before anyone starts shouting at me, this isn't going to be a comparison of who is a better character or who was a better ladybug. If you want to talk about that, then the comments section is there for a reason, so go for it, tear each other to shreds, and I'll have fun reading it later. I am a very superficial person, and I also have an interest in fashion, so as a result, we are going to be very superficially analysing and comparing their outfits, not them as people, just their clothes, okay? However, just because I have an interest in fashion and read more books and magazines about it than I do about my PhD subject, that doesn't mean you can't disagree with me. I actively encourage you to start an argument with me in the comments. So let's start by breaking down Alia's outfit since it's new, and Thomas Astruc thankfully released this to give us more insight into his design, and let's actually start with the hair. So Thomas Astruc notes that it's 60s inspired, and after doing some research and examining the hair from the front and the back in the episode, with the way the hair is slicked back and then slightly raised at the front and then curled up at the ends, it looks like what was called the flick up, along with a wide headband, which is also a style common for the 60s, particularly with the way Alia is wearing it where it comes down onto her forehead. On the design, we can also see another hairstyle which was considered, which seems to be an afro from the drawing, which is also a hairstyle that rose to prominence in the 60s. Prior to the 60s, many women of colour had straightened their hair due to what was considered socially acceptable, but the American Civil Rights Movement influenced more women to not straighten their hair and let it be natural, as a statement of identity and pride, but as we move through the 60s, it also became a fashion trend. Honestly, I think Alia would have looked great with either hairstyle, but I think they went with the flick up over the afro since it's more similar to Alia's civilian hair in the show. However, a lot of the heroes now in the show don't have similar hair to their civilian form. Chloe, Zoe, Julika, Max and Rose's hair are quite different, as is Marinette's as Multi Mouse, and we can't even see Malen's hair, or Adrian's when he's Aspic, which was the wrong decision entirely. That look will give me nightmares forever. The ends of the hair are coloured, which I'm assuming is a reference to how the ends of Alia's hair are different as Rena Rouge, and speaking of which, let's talk about that mask. It matches the shape of the Rena Rouge mask, which I absolutely love, and the front of the blouse slash jacket portion curves inwards in the middle, like on the Rena Rouge design. And I think this jacket is absolutely genius, especially the back of it, because it's mimicking ladybug wings. Now, the back isn't on this draft of the design, so I don't know if this was intentional or just like a nice detail they added in, but to me, the tails, let's call them tails, I guess, the tails remind me of how the shell of a ladybug lifts up and separates when they fly off. Like I said, I don't know if it was intentional, but that's what it reminds me of, and the first time I saw it, I nearly started clapping. It's a stroke of genius, even if unintentional. I really like the sleeves and how it mimics fingerless gloves, and the shorts do seem like a very Alia item of clothing, as she wears shorts as her pyjamas, and she was also in her pyjamas the first time she used the Fox Miraculous in Sapetes, so it's quite fitting really. I don't have much to say about the leggings and the boots other than I like them. Honestly, I only really have one problem with the outfit, and it's this, where the mask and the headband touch. I can't stop staring at it. For some reason, my brain can't get past the pattern clash here. I have no problem with the jacket and the shorts overlapping, but the headband and the mask, it's messing with my head. I don't know what's right. It's a no, I hate it. I just feel weird looking at it, but I think that's entirely a me problem, so don't worry about it. So now we've analysed the full outfit, it's time to compare. First up, Alia wins for the hair, no questions asked. And I'm just gonna say it now, Adrian, I love you. You know I do. You know I want to adopt you. But this outfit wasn't it, Chief. I think it might just be because red definitely isn't Adrian's colour, but no, it's a no. So it's between Marinette and Alia for first place, and I'm going to give it, you're all going to hate me, but I'm going to give it to Marinette. This has nothing to do with which girl I prefer over the other. Between the two of them, I actually like Adrian more, and between the three of them, Mr. Banana is a far better character, and his outfit is the best in the show, and no, I will not be taking constructive criticism on that point, please and thank you. So why does Marinette win? Because of French style. Let me explain. So Miraculous Ladybug, as a show, has a fairly large focus on fashion. Marinette wants to be a designer. Daddy Agrest is a designer. Adrian is a model, so is Lila, I think. I don't know what she's doing, I'll be honest. Julika wants to be one, and Audrey is the owner of a fashion house. And by the way, her personality and character design are based off Anna Wintour, the editor-in-chief of Vogue, who Meryl Streep's character in The Devil Wears Prada is based off. Not only that, we've had several episodes now with a focus on fashion. For example, Mr. Pigeon, Style Queen, Reflectol, Optigami, Ladybug and Queen Banana. And the show is set in Paris, which is arguably the fashion capital of the world. And French style, in particular Parisian style, is characterised by its chicness, its simplicity and its effortless style. Does Marinette wear what is essentially a polka dot onesie? Yes, but the key, in my opinion, to a great outfit, I don't know how this turned into me giving you fashion tips, but the key is to be simple and not overcomplicate things. Now, I'm not saying Ali's design is overly busy, I don't think it is, and the design really suits her, as does the design for Adrian. But Marinette's Ladybug design is, in my opinion, iconic, and I love it. The designers would have to try very hard to beat this outfit. So there you go, that's what I think, but maybe I shouldn't have said anything at all, but it's completely fine if you disagree with me. Style is very subjective, and the world would be a really boring place if we all dressed the same. I just ask that you be respectful in the comments. So who do you think has the best Ladybug outfit? I'll see you in the next one.